So how do you stretch in carpet? Get it nice and tight, and when you drop your cell phone on it, it just bounces right back into your hand. In this video, I'm gonna walk you right through that. So what's good? It's Carpet Mike here from CarpetExpertBlueprint.com, bringing you the tips, tricks, and strategies to be more successful in the carpet and flooring industry. But we need to know how to stretch carpet in, get it to stick to the tack strip, and get those bubbles out of the middle of the room. So let's walk through this here. We got some old janky tack strip. Probably could have replaced this tack strip in all reality, but that's okay. We're rolling with what we got. We're reinforcing it with some sinker nails because we're going to use a crab stretcher to help pull everything nice and tight. So every 8 inches or so, we're going to go ahead and throw a little sinker nail in there, and we got a wood sub floor, so everything's good. Just work our way across, reinforce it, and then we're going to flop that carpet down. Next, we're going to go ahead and bring the crab stretcher into place. Now, if you're a DIY person, you're like, dude, what is that thing? I'm not trying to mess with that. Don't worry. I'm going to walk you through how to use a knee kicker as well. But in this one, we reinforced it for the crab stretcher. So we latch that onto the other side of the tack strip. And now look at that. We're just using that crank to pull all that slack across the room. Look at that nice bubble right there. Oh, that is good. Everything's nice and tight. Now we're going to go ahead and get our knee kicker. Hopefully you got some good knees. You didn't damage them already in the game of life. If you did, go ahead and call somebody to do this for you. But if you got them good knees, we're going to go ahead and take that knee kicker, plant it about 2 inches away from the baseboard, and give it a blast with that knee, stretching that bubble up and locking it onto the tack strip. Next, we're going to go ahead and peel it back again. We're going to look for where those sinker nails were at. Latch that onto the tack strip. Look at that there. Now, the reason I put my knee on it is I like to have enough pressure on it so that it's really biting down into the carpet and pulling it as strong as possible for me. Because if you don't, it could just rake itself right across the top of the carpet and create an ugly disaster. So I'm just giving a little assist with my knee there, and now I'm blasting on with the knee kicker, and that's really all there is to it. When you kick it with the knee kicker, you're going to push the carpet down onto the tack strip with your thumb, getting the nails to go into the backing of the carpet, and then you see me take that linoleum knife there. I'm just using that to go ahead and crease it. Now I'm taking my knife and lobbing off this excess there. So we just work with a section at a time there, just tuckety tuck, work our way across, tuck it in. All right, cool. Let's go on to the next section here. Just take your knife. Now, if you have nice baseboards, do not cut it the way I'm cutting it. You would fold the carpet back and trim it from the backing or use a wall trimmer. Now, with these super janky baseboards, you could just run your blade along it. Watch that. Wah! Lob it right off. Good to go. Take your linoleum knife, tuck it in, and that's all there is to it. Let's speed things up here. Now, if you didn't have the crab stretcher, look how I'm kicking here. All crazy insane like that. That's all you got to do. Just keep the kicker head about 2 inches away from the wall. Kick it up, push it down onto the tack strip with your thumb, and then move the kicker head basically 2 kicker head spaces over each time. So you kick it, move it about roughly 6 to 8 inches over, you kick it again, 6 to 8 inches over, kick it again, and just push it down onto the tack strip, crease it on when you're all done, and then trim it in, you're good to go. That's all there is to it. Now watch that. You've just became a professional carpet and flooring installer. That's all it takes to get in the game. Buy a couple tools, clackety-clack, stretch it in, and you're making bank. If you got any questions, go ahead and drop those down below, and I'll see you in the next video.